If you are going on an Antarctic cruise, chances are you will have a pre-cruise stay at Buenos Aires before flying to Ushuaia. In this video, I will show you some of the most interesting attractions to visit while you are there. Coming up next. Hi fellow travelers, this is Ken and welcome to my channel, Ken Travels 360. We visited some of the most interesting attractions in Buenos Aires before our Antarctica cruise, and without further ado, let's go straight in. The first attraction that people usually think of when Buenos Aires is mentioned is probably Casa Rosada. Casa Rosada means the pink house. You can certainly see how pink it is. It was the balcony here that Eva Perón famously addressed her supporters.
It houses the Argentine president's office, but unlike the White House, the president of Argentina doesn't live here.
Casa Rosada is located at the eastern end of Plaza de Mayo. Ever since the foundation of Buenos Aires in 1580, Plaza de Mayo has been Buenos Aires' symbolic and political heart.
Surrounded by Casa Rosada and the Cabildo, which is the city hall, and the Catedral Metropolitana, this is where Argentines gather in protest or celebration. At the center is the Piramide de Mayo, a white obelisk built to commemorate the first anniversary of the independence from Spain. Every Thursday at 3:30, you can see the Madres de la Plaza de Mayo gather here and circle the pyramid. They hold the photographs of their missing children. During the military dictatorship between 1976 to 1983, many young Argentines were abducted and disappeared by the state.
Next, let's go check out the Metropolitan Cathedral of Buenos Aires.
We are now inside the Catedral Metropolitana. This cathedral was built on the site of the original colonial church, and it was only completed in 1827. It's a significant religious and architectural landmark in Buenos Aires. The interior is very spacious, with lots of Baroque details and an elegant Rococo altar. The current Pope, Pope Francis, used to perform Mass here as Archbishop Jorge Bergoglio before assuming office in the Vatican in 2013. In his honor, the cathedral now houses the Pope Francis Museum, which exhibits some of his personal and liturgical objects. The cathedral is also a national historical site that contains the mausoleum of General José de San Martín, Argentina's most revered hero, who led the country to independence in 1816. In the chaos that followed, Saint Martin chose exile in France, never returning to Argentina. His remains were brought to Buenos Aires in 1888, 30 years after his death.
After the Metropolitan Cathedral, we'll visit the Cabildo next door. The Cabildo is a mid-18th century town hall building that was used during the colonial era, but nowadays is a museum dedicated to the revolution of May 1810, when Argentina declared independence from Spain. The museum is free entry, and inside they have paintings, clothes, and artifacts from the 18th century. And from the second floor balcony, there are good views of Plaza de Mayo. In fact, when we were there, we saw the weekly gathering or protest by the Madres de la Plaza de Mayo Association there. At this point, I would like to talk about how we got around in Buenos Aires. Sure, they have a subway called Subte, but it's not really useful for tourists. Instead, we use an app called Cabify, which basically works like Uber, and it allowed us to get private transport really cheaply. In fact, our transfer earlier from Ezeiza Airport to our hotel Anselmo in San Telmo area cost only £11 or $13. Okay, it's time for afternoon tea, and we're gonna visit the famous Café Tortoni.
So right now, I'm outside Café Tortoni. Let's go inside to have a look. It's the oldest and most famous cafe in Buenos Aires.
So Steve's had ordered a cafe espresso with a churro.
And we have both ordered alcohol as well.
Café Tortoni was rated as one of the 10 most beautiful cafes in the world. And over the years, it was visited by many famous people, including Albert Einstein, Hillary Clinton, Robert Duvall, Katy Perry, and Francis Ford Coppola, to name just a few. After the afternoon tea, we went back to San Telmo, where our hotel is located at, and we visited the San Telmo Market.
So we are now in the San Telmo Market, Mercado de San Telmo, and there are lots of very interesting shops and lots of different eateries, and there are lots of shops selling dulce de leche as well. So we will have a look around.
So for dinner, we have gone back to the San Telmo Market, and we've gone to this Fonda Argentine food to have a beef de chorizo. That's our beef de chorizo being cooked.
So we ordered the steak al punto. That's basically medium rare. Oh, the beer has just arrived. It's a pint of beer.
So the beef de chorizo has arrived.
Next, I want to talk about the situation of money. You might have read about the hyperinflation in Argentina and how you could exchange double the amount of Argentine peso by changing your US dollar at exchange kiosks that offers blue dollar rate. However, since December 2022, the Argentinian government changed the rule so that tourists paying with a foreign credit or debit card would receive the blue dollar rate. And indeed, we used that to our advantage. We only changed $200 in cash, and we paid the rest using our credit card.
Buenos dias, it's Friday morning and we are going out now. We are going to the area La Boca, and we are going to an area called El Caminito. It's a very colorful district. To go there, we are going to use Cabify again. I just requested a ride, and Fernando will be here in 3 minutes.
So this is the hotel that we are staying in, Anselmo Hotel.
So we are on our ride to El Caminito, and here is the Modern Arts Museum. Okay, right now we're in La Boca. It's one of the poorest areas of Buenos Aires. However, there is a part of it that is more tourist friendly. It's called Caminito. This area is a street museum of colorful painted houses,
typical of the immigrant dwellings that came to characterize this portside area towards the end of the 19th and the start of the 20th century. The Caminito, which means little path in Spanish, followed the route of an old stream that once flowed into the Riachuelo. After the river dried up, it became part of a railroad route. When the railroad was closed, the street was largely abandoned until in the 1950s, when a group of neighbors decided to regenerate the area, and local artist Benito Quinquela Martin began using the tenements as his canvas. These tenements buildings are called conventillos, and on the outside, you can find figures of Juan and Eva Perón, Che Guevara, and football legend Diego Maradona, who wave down from balconies.
Earlier, the conventillo is not open, but finally, this one is now open, so we're gonna go in to see what it's like.
The buildings are made of wood and zinc metal sheets. They were originally brushed with leftover paint that Genoese immigrants got from the ships. Inside, you will find boarding houses with many rooms, all around a central courtyard with a common cooking area. Many of these conventillos are built on raised foundations due to frequent floods in the past.
So we're right now inside one of these traditional conventillos. They have lots of tenements here where people used to live. This day is all gentrified and it's just tourist facilities now.
There are two persons who are very popular here, Pope Francis and the late Diego Maradona. Everywhere you go, you can see them. Diego Maradona was of course absolutely worshipped here, as he played for Boca Juniors for 5 years before moving to Europe.
Maradona and Messi seems to be the theme everywhere, particularly during the World Cup.
You can see the blue and yellow colors of Boca Juniors everywhere in this area.
So it looks like I've just stumbled upon the souvenir shop of Boca Juniors. They basically sell two things here, Argentinian jersey and Boca Junior jerseys, nothing else. This is the Fundación Poa. It's just outside the Caminito area. So we have finished visiting the Caminito area.
And next, we are gonna head to Recoleta, which is probably the most upscale area in Buenos Aires.
If you have been enjoying this video, please give me a thumbs up. And if you are interested to see how the Antarctica cruise is like, I strongly recommend you subscribe to my channel with notifications turned on. That way, you'll be notified whenever I release a new video.
For lunch, we decided to get empanadas at this place called El San Juanino.
So the whole restaurant is full, so we have ordered takeaway instead. We have ordered two carne suave and two jamón y queso.
Right, so this is a takeaway empanada. Let's see how they look like.
So we're near the Recoleta Cemetery now. Wow, look at this amazing tree. They even got a sculpture so that it looks like it's holding it up. So behind me is the Basilica Nuestra Senora the Pillar. So right now, I have just arrived at the world famous Recoleta Cemetery. This is arguably Buenos Aires' most important attractions. So last time when I visited Buenos Aires, I visited Recoleta Cemetery and it was definitely free admission. But now there is an admission fee of 400 pesos for tourists to go in. This is the first time I have to pay admission to get inside a cemetery. Wow, we just find out actually the admission is not 400 pesos, but 1,400 pesos per person. It's really expensive. That's $4-5 to visit a cemetery. See, unless you're well versed in Argentine history, you are unlikely to recognize any of the names here. This one is also very dramatic. What I find quite interesting is that there is no consistency in the architectural style of the mausoleum. That's quite obvious because everyone will probably just want to build it in their own style. So there is a real mishmash of styles around.
Finally, we found the grave of Eva Perón, and this is probably the most visited tomb of the Recoleta Cemetery. Although Eva Perón died in 1952, her body wasn't buried here for 20 years due to political reasons. Interestingly, she was buried in the Duarte family mausoleum. Duarte is her maiden name. Juan Perón was buried in a grand mausoleum built by loyal Peronists in the rural town of San Vicente. She was buried in a heavily fortified crypt 5 meters underground. This is the tomb of Argentina's 7th president, Domingo Sarmiento. The tomb features a soaring obelisk crowned with a huge condor. He designed the tomb himself before his death.
Expectamus Dominum. Well, excuse my ignorance in Latin, but it sounds like something Harry Potter would say in casting a spell. So I think we have all seen enough of all these mausoleum. We are finishing the Recoleta Cemetery now. We're gonna go to another attraction.
Before we visit to the next attraction, we are gonna get an ice cream for Freddo. I remember having my first ever Dolce de Leche ice cream here in 2007 when I last visited Recoleta Cemetery. More than 15 years later, it's time to try it again.
So I just finished the gelato from Freddo. It was really messy, so I couldn't really film at that time. The ice cream, the gelato, was really good. It's almost Italian gelato quality, but not quite. It's still as good as I remember it from all those years ago. So I'm on the Dr. Alfredo Roque Ritolo pedestrian bridge. Behind me, the impressive sculpture is called Floralis Genérica. It's a sculpture dedicated to the city by the architect Eduardo Catalano. It's supposed to look like a flower that opens in the morning and then closes in the evening. But I've read that it has been broken for a while. And to me, it looks like it's a little bit closed, not that open. So maybe that's it.
And with that, it's time for us to go to Sofitel to start our pre-Antarctica cruise program. If you would like to find out what happened from Buenos Aires to boarding our ship in Ushuaia, click on the link on the screen now. I'll see you over there.